Hey, I'm Jamin.
And I'm Amanda, and in this video, we're going to show you how to create a Gantt chart for your project.
We know a good project plan is the key to keeping you and your team on the right track. Good planning means smooth sailing.
A Gantt chart is a great way to visualize your whole project in a timeline. And with TeamGantt, getting started is as easy as pie.
I love pie!
Today we're going to teach you how to create a project, create and edit tasks, organize those tasks into subgroups, invite and assign people and resources, and track progress over time with the help of baselines. That may seem like a lot to cover in a single video, but trust us, TeamGantt makes all of that super easy and quick.
Creating a new project starts at the New Project screen. To get there from the home screen, click the Create a New Project button.
Now name your project and decide whether you want to create a blank project or use one of the default templates.
If you want, you can pick which days of the week you'd like to include in your project's timeline. Just toggle them on or off from here. When you're happy with how you've set up your project, click Create New Project.
There you go. You've created a new project. Now on to the fun part, adding tasks.
A Gantt chart is really just all the things you need to get done for your project laid out in a timeline. Let's start with a task.
As you can see, your TeamGantt project starts with one task already in the timeline, with a start date of today.
You can name it whatever you want. Seriously, you can call it literally anything that comes to mind.
But you should probably stick to naming it what you actually want to accomplish.
That's true.
Once you have it named, just drag it to wherever you want to schedule it in the timeline and resize it to adjust the duration. If you want to change your task's color, that's easy too. Just mouse over the task and click on the color icon that appears to the right. Select the color you want your task to be, and it immediately changes to that color.
To add another task, mouse over the column with your task's name, and under your task will be some options of things you can add to your Gantt chart. Click on Add Task, and a new task is added. Name your new task and drag it into the timeline to schedule it. Once again, you can resize the task to adjust its duration.
You can also do this by double-clicking on the taskbar and adjusting the start and end dates from within the task detail window.
To delete a task, click on the X that appears near the task's name when you mouse over it. You'll be asked if you're sure if you want to delete the task. If you are, click Yes.
Update progress on your tasks by adjusting the percent complete column in the task row. If you don't see the percent complete column, you can toggle it on or off from the view dropdown. You can double-click on the task and adjust your progress from the task detail window as well. Repeat the process to add and schedule as many tasks as you need, and you're on your way to having an awesome Gantt chart for your project. TeamGantt allows you to organize your tasks into collapsible subgroups to make it a cinch to arrange and order your project into clean, easy-to-view categories. Your project defaults to having one group automatically in the timeline. You can edit the name of the group the same way you edit a task name. Just click on the group name to rename it.
To add new group, mouse over the column with your task and group names and click Add New Group from the options under the bottom task. Name your new group, and you can start adding tasks to it.
You can also move tasks from one group to another by clicking and dragging the drag handle that appears to the left of the task when you mouse over it. You can also use this to reorder tasks within a group. Collapse a group by clicking the disclosure triangle to the left of the group name.
The gray bar in the task group row is the progress bar for the task group. If you mouse over the bar, some options appear to the right of it. Click the color icon to change the color for all the tasks within the group.
Grouping tasks is a great way to organize your Gantt chart, but these tasks aren't going to do themselves. It's time to add some people and resources.
People and resources are the key to getting the project done, and adding them is super easy with TeamGantt. Just mouse over the taskbar that you want to add a person or resource to, and click the person icon that appears to the taskbar's right. Any person or resource that has been added to the project is available to select right away. If you don't see the person or resource you're looking for, you can add them by clicking Add New Person Resource and adjust resource colors, or by clicking the People tab. Then click Add Manage People or Add Manage Resources to add the person or resource to the project. Click on the Enter Name field to search for the name of the person you want to add to the project. If they're not listed, click Add New. Type in their name and email address and select the level of control you want them to have in the project and click Done. You can edit the default message or write your own and click Send Invitations. You can immediately add them to your project even before they receive the invitation and join the project. Click the Gantt tab to go back to your Gantt chart, and now, when you select the person icon, the person you added will appear. Now select the people and resources you want to add to the task, and click Done. You can see the person and resource names added to the task to the right of the taskbar. This can be toggled on and off from the View dropdown.
I guess we should assign ourselves to this task, huh?
Now that we have some tasks in our project and assigned to people, it's time to get working on these tasks so we can stay on schedule.
It's great to have a tight plan, but we all know that sometimes even the most well-thought-out plans hit bumps in the road and tasks can slip and start to run over their scheduled time.
It might be impossible to avoid going over some deadlines in the real world, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't have the tools to help identify trends in your plan so you can keep them at a minimum.
Baselines give you a snapshot of your project progress at a given point in time so that you can see if there are tasks that are running on time, ahead, or most importantly, behind schedule.
Creating a baseline set is super easy, and you can create as many sets as you want in a project. Just click on Menu, then Baselines, then Create New Baseline Set. Your new baseline set is created so you can see where your project runs ahead of schedule or falls behind.
Well, there you go.
That was fun.
Go to TeamGantt.com and create an easy, beautiful project plan in no time.